Hello everyone, welcome to a small terrible channel. Again, this is Mama Senho. By the way, thank you so much sa mga sumusubaybay sa ating paggawa ng module na self learning para sa mga estudyante. Okay, so tingnan natin itong nagawa ko na. So nagawa ko na hanggang module 5 sa first quarter using the most essential learning competencies. Alright, so tingnan natin. Okay. So ito ang table of contents until module 5, yan. Okay, tingnan natin. I-next lang natin, ha? So gamit itong, ito ay naka-desktop screen. Pag full view, yan. Yan ang makikita natin. So sa full view muna na tayo. Okay, using the full view, i-next lang natin. Okay, in module 1, so using the MELC, the MELC or the most essential learning competencies, ito ang topic natin. Describe the components of a scientific investigation. So this is good for 1 week. Okay, so in this module, you will learn to describe the components of a scientific investigation. So going back to the most essential learning competencies, so it's describe the components of a scientific investigation. So our module here is aligned to the MELC. So our targets, pasensya na tayo, nandito ako sa manukan. Your targets at the end of this module, number 1, define scientific method. Number 2, list the steps of the scientific method. And number 3, show example problem solved using the scientific or using the steps of the scientific method. So itong tatlong target na ito ang objective natin sa module 1. Unlocking of difficulties. So itong mga words na ito ay makikita natin as we move, as we go on sa module na ito, kaya kailangan i-unlock muna natin para ang estudyante ay hindi maka ano, hindi mahihirapan na mag-guess kung ano ba ang word na ito. Okay, so hypothesis, testable statement, manipulated variable also called independent variable, responding variable also called dependent variable. So, okay na tayo dyan. Proceed na tayo sa next page. Try this. So, itong try this is a pre-test or the pre-assessment for the students to gauge if they have a prior knowledge about this topic, scientific investigation. So, all they have to do is they are going to tick, okay, or they are going to click on the circle here. If it's true, click on the true circle. Then if it's false, click on the false circle. Then afterwards, all you have to do is submit the answer. Okay? So, as you can notice, question 1 and question 2 is incorrect. Question 3 until 5 is correct. So in question 1, for example, it's incorrect. Why? Because the my answer is true, but the correct answer is false. And take note, the correct answer is already highlighted with a green color. So this makes the student makikita niya kung ano talaga ang tama at hindi siya maging confused. Then, pagkatapos, i-okay lang natin. Then, proceed to the next page. Do this. So, itong do this ay isang activity regarding the steps of the scientific method wherein the student will click on the picture, then the label is just below it. So, for example, this picture, this depict asking a question, which is the first step of the scientific method. Then we have the second picture referring to the second step of the scientific method, do background research. Then the third step of the scientific method. This is the third picture. Construct a hypothesis. Then test your hypothesis by doing an experiment. Then we have analyze your data and draw a conclusion. Then we have communicating results, the last step of the scientific method. Afterwards, they are just going to click the X button here. Then proceed to the next page. So we have here a video, again made by yours truly. So hindi ko na inilagay sa references. Okay. Okay, so this video is located in my YouTube channel, so I just embed it here in my module, in the module that I am making. So anybody is free to embed this video to their module if they want to. So in this video, I have given the examples of the steps of the scientific method. So there's also the English version of this. So this one is the Bisaya version because my target audience for this module are my students, my students here in Cebu. Okay, but there's also the English version. Just browse my, or I am going to place the English version of this scientific method below this Bisaya version. I'm going to edit my video later on. So in this video, so I have mentioned already the examples of each step. Okay, so it's very important for you to really watch it, because the steps, the examples for each steps are in here. Then afterwards, after watching this video, here we have another activity. Okay, so this is a word search. So every time the student can get or can find the correct word, it will just highlight. For example, this one, communication of results. So it will highlight to the correct description. Next is we have what else? Do you still have the words? I can't find it. All right, so the students will really like this because especially if they will be challenged to look for the words, and they are going to, like, for example, communication of results, they will realize, that is the last step in scientific investigation, communication of results. All right, so hindi pa tayo nakapunta sa abstraction part or sa discussion part, pero dito sa activity, may ano na sila, may natutunan na sila. Ito pala yung last step in a scientific investigation, communication of results. And, okay, pagkatapos nila, mag-highlight lang ito lahat kapag nakikita na lahat ng words. Okay, so i-delete lang natin para sa para ready tayo kapag i-share na natin ito sa mga estudyante. Hindi na nila makikita na nak-highlight na yan. So, i-delete lang natin yan. Okay? So, pagkatapos na nitong explore portion, pupunta na naman tayo sa next page. Dito na ang discussion part. Keep this in mind. So, this is the abstraction part. So, our task here is to just read. So in here, I have mentioned, I have, okay, I have list down the 6 steps of the scientific method. I have something lacking that I remember. I have to define here also the scientific method before giving the 6 steps. So I forgot. So the next time to I am going to sa susunod na ipapakita ko sa inyo ito, nandito na ang definition ni scientific method. Kasi yan ang first objective natin. We need to define the scientific method. Okay, so going back, so we have the 6 steps to a scientific method. First is asking a question. It starts with how, what, when, who, which, why, or when. So, for example, all you have to do is you click on the highlighted word example, and the example is how do new organisms come into being. So that is our example of the first step of the scientific method. Next is doing background research. So it describes why you are doing the experiment. So that is the second step of the scientific method. So for example, all you have to do is you click on the highlighted word example, then it will pop out as this. At the time, people believed that organisms suddenly appeared from non-living matter. Example, maggots from meat, mice from grain. This idea was called spontaneous generation, wherein life could arise from non-living matter. So that is our example of doing background research. The third step of the scientific method is construct a hypothesis. It is a possible or hypothesis is a possible logical answer to a scientific question. And also, a hypothesis is a testable statement. So take note, these words that I used here are also, they also appeared in our activity regarding word search. Okay, example for construct a hypothesis. In 1668, Francesco Redi proposed and thought that flies laid eggs on the meat, but the eggs were just too small for people to see. He thought that the eggs then developed into maggots. So the hypothesis of Francesco Redi is that flies laid eggs on the meat. Then the eggs developed into maggots. That's the hypothesis of Francesco Redi. So take note, it's a logical answer to a scientific question. So what's the scientific question? That was the first step, which is how do new organisms come into being? Let's proceed to the fourth step of the scientific method, testing your hypothesis by doing an experiment. So to test a hypothesis, you first need to have a prediction. So a prediction tells what will happen under certain conditions. Again, this appeared in our activity in the explore part. Next, you must gather evidence to test your prediction. So evidence is any type of data that may either agree or disagree with a prediction, so it may either support or disprove a hypothesis. So evidence may be gathered by an experiment. What is an experiment? It is a controlled scientific study of specific variables. Again, this appeared in our activity in the explore part. So the variables involved are independent variable, so it's highlighted, right? So you can click that. We say highlighted means it's of different color than the rest. The rest are black, but this one is, or this, there are highlighted words colored blue. So for example, independent variable or manipulated variable is a factor that is changed by the researcher. Take note of this. Again, this appeared in our activities. And this will appear also in our incoming activities. Okay, then for the dependent variable, okay, so I remember there's the two comma here. So by the way, this way of having our is a way of proofreading as well. So we are proofreading as well this one so that it would be ready for our students. Okay, going back. Okay, so we are in the keep this in mind. Okay, so